Hi, IB Economics students. Do you find it extremely time-consuming to sketch graphs for your IB Economics assignments such as your IB Economics IA? Today, I'm going to share with you the ultimate hack you can use to actually sketch your graphs in the shortest possible time. My name is Belva. I'm an IB Trained Economics tutor, and I've helped many students excel in IB Economics using our tried and tested method. So just take a look at all the reviews that my students have given me. Okay, I'm going to show you an example of how the demand and supply diagram is drawn using this template that I've created. So all you need to do is paste the URL code that is found in the description box below and make a copy. And straight away, once you click on make a copy, this copy, exact same copy, will be made in your Google Drive. So be sure you log into your Google Drive when you do this. Okay, so I'm going to show you an example of how the graph would change if there is an increase in the price of a substitute of a good. Okay, so with an increase in the price of a substitute, definitely the demand for the good will increase. So I'm going to click on the demand curve here. A line has already been drawn for you. So let's push it there. And then right now, the demand has shifted upwards. So I can key that in. I have a dash here. And there you go. I have showed you how we can modify this to suit your needs. So easy, isn't it? And then all you need to do, you can download this graph in any form, JPEG, PDF, and use it for your assignments. I've included some of these templates for you to draw your IB Economics diagrams for all your assignments with greater ease. Okay, so all the links are found in the description box below. So when you click on the link, you will come to a document like this. It will say copy document. This is for one of the templates, which is the negative externalities of consumption. So all you need to do is to click on make a copy, and automatically the copy will be made and saved into your Google Drive. But first of all, you must remember to log into your Google Drive to be able to access these documents. Okay, so there we go. We have this template here already drawn for you, which is the negative externalities of consumption diagram. Your marginal private benefit is above the marginal social benefit due to the negative externality of consumption. And you have your supply curve here, as you can see from my cursor. And all the points have been identified on the diagram, which is the socially optimal output, which is much lower than the market equilibrium output Q1. Okay. So say if I have a case whereby I need to include taxes to actually reduce the consumption of the good due to the fact that it creates negative effects on third parties. So what I can do is I have included some of these lines and labels over here. So when you include taxes, then the supply curve will shift to the left because the cost of production will be higher due to the taxes. So I can shift this line here and I can use this label, supply plus tax. And I can lengthen this dotted line to show that I actually achieved the socially optimal output, which is QSOC here. Okay, so there we go. We have all the diagram laid out nicely. So that's all you need to do. Isn't it easy? I'll show you one more example of how the graph template can be used to do your economics assignments. Okay, here, click on the link in the description box below and you can find one for Monopolistic Competition. So make a copy. And there you go, you can see this is an example of a monopolistic competitive firm earning normal profits. So say, for instance, if I wish to show that the firm is making losses instead of profits, all I need to do is to make some slight adjustments. I can shift the AC higher. Okay, but make sure as you do so, the MC still cuts the AC at its minimum point because that's the rule you have to follow. Okay, so you can see with this, the firm is now making losses. All right, I can draw a line across here. And I can change it to dotted, after which I can lengthen this line because the profit maximization point still occurs at the same point. Just note that profit maximization is actually equal to loss minimization as well. So the output doesn't change because MC curve stays the same. So I just shift the AC curve only, make minimal changes to make things a lot easier. So there we go. I have now a graph that is making losses. I hope you found the IB Economics graph templates useful for writing your IB Economics assignments. As you already know by now, the IB Economics curriculum underwent a major revamp in 2022. There were many changes made, including your IB Economics internal assessment. If you'd like to score a level 7 for your IB Economics internal assessment, do watch my YouTube video for some simple tips on how you can score a level 7 for your IB Economics internal assessment. So I hope to see you soon in my next video. Do not forget to like, subscribe, and comment. So see you soon.